This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through patreon.com/GeneralPack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies. In this video tutorial part 1, we're going to be reviewing a book by Granger and Stevenson, and specifically on chapter number 12 on unsymmetrical fault types. And the topic of this conversation is building the symmetrical component sequence network diagrams. So this book can be purchased on Amazon, and it's a costly book, but it's one of those books that that can be used throughout your career, not just the student or book work, but throughout the career. And I personally use this book all the time. I have a hard copy and I use this book all the time for all sorts of different references in the power systems industry. So highly recommend purchasing this book and having it on your shelf. Now, in chapter number 12, in this part at least, we're going to just introduce what we're going to talk about in the subsequent parts. But in this chapter, we go over a lot of different types of faults involved. And we'll be talking about three-phase faults, single-line-to-ground faults, line-to-line fault, and double line-to-ground fault. These four different fault types. And again, really delving into how to construct the sequence network diagrams based off of the type of fault and the equations that are involved. So, and just to give you a reference, so that we can have a good level set of mind when we're thinking about these three types of faults. A three-phase fault is a fault that has all three phases touching each other, and it may or may not touch the ground. At the end of the day, they're the same fault type. And you have fault currents that are going through each of these three phases, and typically the fault current is a perfectly balanced fault current, which means that phase currents on A, B, and C are the same magnitude and 120 degrees displaced. And you may have this ZF, which is the fault impedance, which means it's an extra impedance that may be on the line or externally that contributes and or reduces the fault current as a whole. So that's what ZF is, just this extra impedance that may be encountered with the fault, right? So a three-phase fault, perfectly balanced in terms of symmetric components. We only have the positive sequence component involved because it's a perfectly balanced fault. The negative and zero sequence components do not exist for a three-phase fault, right? Perfectly balanced three-phase fault. Now, single line to ground fault is a fault in which one of the phases touch the ground, right? And you may or may not have fault impedance ZF involved. And so you may have a phase A to ground fault, phase B to ground fault, or phase C to ground fault, but typically one of the phases touches the ground. And at the type, at the inception of the fault, fault current would only be, would only exist on one of the phases, the fault phase, right? And the other phases would just simply have load currents. But the fault current would be considerably larger than the load current. So that's for single, in terms of symmetrical components, single line to ground faults only have, single line to ground faults have positive, negative, and zero sequence components. And typically all three components are the same magnitude and the same angle. For a line-to-line fault, however, it does not involve a ground mode, and because it doesn't involve a ground mode, we should not see zero sequence components. In fault, line-to-line fault, two phases are faulted together. In this case, it's fault B, line B and line C are faulted together, are touching each other, and you may or may not have a fault impedance in between. But you may also have A to B faulted together or A to C faulted together. In this case, it's B to C. And in this type of fault type, again, like we mentioned, it does not have a ground mode, but you can expect a positive sequence and negative sequence fault current between them. Again, line current B for your faulted current and then line current C for the faulted current are typically of the same current and the same magnitude. Typically, line current B and line current C are equivalent. And then line current A, your unfaulted phase, is the phase that just has your load current during the inception of the fault. For a double line to ground fault, however, you do have two different faults or two different lines that are in contact with each other, but you also have a contact to ground. So a double line to ground fault kind of looks like this, where you have these two currents, and they may not be as symmetrical as your line-to-line fault, right? And so they'll have different fault currents and different angle because you have the ground involved. And then we may also have a fault impedance involved, right? And so again, these two currents are about the same, are similar to each other. They may not be the same. And then line A current or the unfaulted phase current will just have load current at the inception of the fault. In terms of symmetrical component, a double line to ground fault will have positive, negative, and zero sequence components involved. Now in the next part, we will be talking about three-phase faults in much more detail, and then single line to ground fault, line to line fault, and double line to ground fault, and look at how the sequence network diagrams are derived. Thank you.